Good evening, my dear friends, and welcome to Evening Vespers on this beautiful feast of Christ's Mother, Our Lady of Lourdes. I'm sure many of you will have known about Lourdes, that amazing miraculous shrine in France. And for our Catholic brothers and sisters, we wish you a happy feast day in honor of Our Lady of Lourdes. So this evening we have lit our candle, and we offer our prayers this evening for all who are terminally ill or who have intractable illness, and we light this light for them. There is no plant in the ground but tells of your beauty, O Christ. There is no creature on the earth, there is no life in the sea, but proclaims your goodness. There is no bird on the wing, there is no star in the sky, there is nothing beneath the sun, but is full of your blessing. Lighten my understanding of your presence all around, O Christ. Kindle my will to be caring for your creation. And now we begin with the office in honor of Our Lady of Lourdes. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And our hymn this evening, Maiden yet a mother, daughter of thy son, high beyond all other, lowlier is none. Thou the consummation planned by God's decree, when our lost creation nobler rose in thee. Thus his place prepared, he who all things made, mid his creatures tarried, in thy bosom laid. There his love he nourished, warmth that gave increase to the root whence flourished our eternal peace. Nor alone thou hearest when thy name we hail, often thou art nearest when our voices fail. Mirrored in thy fashion, all creation's good, mercy, might, compassion, grace thy womanhood. Lady, lest our vision, striving heavenward fail, still at thy petition with thy Son prevail. Unto whom all merit, power and majesty, with the Holy Spirit and the Father Mother be. The first antiphon, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Alleluia. And now we read Psalm 121. I rejoiced when I heard them say, Let us go to God's house. And now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city, strongly compact. It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. For Israel's law it is, there to praise the Lord's name. There were set the thrones of judgment of the house of David. For the peace of Jerusalem pray, peace be to your homes. May peace reign in your walls, in your palaces, peace. For love of my brethren and friends, I say peace upon you. For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your good. And now we pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Alleluia. And the second antiphon, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be as you have said. Alleluia. And now we read Psalm 126. If the Lord does not build the house, in vain do its builders labor. If the Lord does not watch over the city, in vain does the watchman keep vigil. In vain is your earlier rising, your going later to rest, you who toil for the bread you eat, when he pours gifts on his beloved while they slumber. Truly, sons are a gift from the Lord, a blessing, the fruit of the womb. Indeed, the sons of the youth are like arrows in the hand of a warrior. Oh, the happiness of the man who has filled his quiver with these arrows. He will have no cause for shame when he disputes with his foes in the gateways. And now we pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be as you have said. Alleluia. The third antiphon. You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Alleluia. And now we have a canticle reading from Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. He destined us in love to be his sons and daughters through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious name, which he freely bestowed upon us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespass, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ. His purpose he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things on earth, things in heaven and things on earth. Let us now pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Alleluia. And our scripture reading is from Paul to the Galatians. When the appointed time came, God sent their son, born of a woman, born a subject of the law, the subjects of the law, and to enable us to be adopted as sons and daughters of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now for the short responsory. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. And now for the Magnificat antiphon. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And now, my dear friends, I invite you to join me now for the Magnificat, the Canticle of Mary. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, who is my Savior. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth, all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones, and he exalts the lowly. He fills the starving with good things and sends the rich away empty-handed. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our father Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Excuse me. And now we repeat the Magnificat antiphon. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. You are the most blessed of all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And now we come to our evening intercessions. Let us praise God, our Father, Mother, who chose Mary as the mother of their Son and wanted all generations to call her blessed. With confidence we pray, response, may the Virgin Mary intercede for us. Father, Mother God, you did great things for the Virgin Mary and brought her body and soul to the glory of heaven. Fill the hearts of your children with the hope of Christ's glory. Response, may the Virgin Mary intercede for us. Through the prayers of Mary, our Mother, heal the sick, comfort the sorrowful, pardon sinners, grant peace and salvation to all. Response, may the Virgin Mary intercede for us. May your church be united heart and soul, held fast by love. And may your faithful be joined in continuous prayer with Mary, the Mother of Jesus. Response, may the Virgin Mary intercede for us. Father, Mother God, you exalted the Virgin Mary and crowned her Queen of Heaven. May the dead enter your kingdom and rejoice with your saints forever. Response, may the Virgin Mary intercede for us. And now, my dear friends, let us just spend a moment or two in quietness, and let us come to our spiritual mother, who intercedes for us with her beloved Son, Jesus. So let us share with Mary, our mother, anything that may be troubling us, or some request that we might have. Let us share it with her now. This evening, I pray for each one of you that Mother Mary will overshadow you with her mantle of love and protect you as a heavenly mother. I pray this evening for all the children of God from all faiths and none, all color, all creeds, and those who are hurting, those who've lost faith, those who have given up the ghost, and those who are suffering, really suffering in mind, body, and spirit. We call on our Blessed Mother Mary to intercede for them. This evening we pray to Our Lady, Queen of Peace, for peace in this beautiful world, God's gift to the children of God, and yet we abuse it so, don't we? We destroy the very fabric of creation through greed. Let us pray this evening for those who are really struggling, trying to make ends meet, for those in prison, especially those who've been sent down today and who have a long sentence ahead of them, for those on death row. And we remember all fates and none, that they come together at this table of love, and that they try and become ambassadors of peace and bring the healing touch of their God to their enemy. We pray this evening for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for His Holiness, the Dalai Lama. We pray for the Archbishop of Canterbury and Queen Elizabeth, the reigning monarch and head of the Church of England. And we pray especially for those who are dying this night, for those who are dying alone. Let us be still now, as we pray the beautiful prayer that Mary's Son gave to each one of us. Our Father, Mother God, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give to us tonight our daily bread, and forgive us for the times when we have abused God's will, for the times when we have been stubborn, arrogant, and proud, for the times when we have failed to forgive and forget what others have done to us, for the times when we have failed in charity, in thought, word, or deed. Lead us not astray, O God, but protect us from the forces of darkness, negativity, and evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And our closing prayer on this feast of Our Lady of Lourdes. Lord of mercy, as we keep the memory of Mary, the Immaculate Mother of God, who appeared to Saint Bernadette at Lourdes, grant us through her prayer strength in our weakness and grace to rise up from our sin. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And as it is a special feast for all Catholics, I'm guided to play Friar Alexandro singing Schubert's Ave Maria, which I present to you as a special gift on this beautiful day.
Et mulieribus, et bene.
What a beautiful aria. Well, we wish our Blessed Mother a happy feast day, and as we bring our Vespers to a close, let us bless you with the Celtic blessing, the blessing of heaven, the blessing of earth, the blessing of sea and sky on those we love this day, and on every human family, the gift of heaven, the gift of earth, the gift of sea and sky, the gifts of brother sun and sister moon and the animal kingdom, be in your heart, now and forevermore. Amen. Namaste, shalom. Inshallah pax et bonum om shanti. Solo di caritas, salam alaikum, and may the peace and joy of the risen cosmic Christ and the love of his Blessed Mother be in your heart this night and every night. Amen. So let us go in peace to love and to serve our God. Amen. And before I forget, on Doves for Peace this evening at 8 o'clock, we've got our beautiful Anna Concave sharing with us, and I hope to be back here this evening at 10 o'clock for our vigil. So for now, have a pleasant evening wherever you may be. And to Sister Sue and to little Toby, take care. Shalom.